watching the Hub Network. The Studio Show. People. Community. Progress. Here is your host, Joe Kennedy.
Oh, and that's a big introduction. We have been waiting for that. Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Studio Show. This is happening.
Welcome to special election coverage on the Hub.
Because that is so bad. I thought I took that out of there last week. I've done that like five times and it still hasn't happened.
We have a bird in the room.
Anyway, yes. I'm sorry about that. Welcome to the Studio Show. Gosh, I'm Joe Kennedy. We're here every Wednesday, 10:30 to 11:30. We've got a special guest in the studio. I'm not going to tell you who that is, although you probably know if you've read any of the things.
Sorry, I couldn't help myself.
You wave it. Anyway, we're going to get to her. Plenty of time for that in just a minute. But I'm really excited about having Emily in the studio today. A couple things coming up. Jennifer Hickson's going to be here next week. We're going to be talking about Mother's Day and flowers. And she does some really cool arrangements and stuff. So she's going to show us some of that stuff next week and get you all ready to run down there and buy a bunch of flowers for Mother's Day, which I know all the guys are excited about that. So that is next week. And then after that, we've got others coming in like Dr. Melissa Amon, Superintendent of Cushing Public Schools, Carrie Marks from the Hillcrest Hospital, PR there at the Cushing Regional Hospital. It used to be Cushing Regional Hospital, Hillcrest Hospital. I've got to say that right. I'm showing my age now. And so a lot of good guests coming up and many, many more. We're really booked out until into September. And even I think we just booked one for October the other day. So we've got a lot going on and a lot of good information. The other thing I want to bring up is Cushing Matters. That's going to be kind of a fun thing. We're going to do that around the city commission meetings and kind of do some in-depth dive into the agendas and kind of what's going on. And maybe a little bit of education on how that works and how the city government works. Don Amon is actually going to sit here beside me on that and kind of give us some instruction based on his experience as a commissioner and the former mayor of Cushing. And so we get a little insight from him. And I'm sure there'll be, with Don in the room, I'm sure there'll be a lot of extracurricular conversation about a lot of things going on. So can't really wait for that. That should be entertaining. And the days, the weeks, we're going to do that every month. And of course, the weeks that he can't be here, we'll have others in here. Marilyn Duff and some others have agreed to come in and kind of to be that insight as well. So that's going to be kind of a new thing coming up. And then probably the most exciting thing, we're going back to the coaches show this year. So after the games, I think on Sunday afternoon, we're going to have Coach Morgan with us and we're going to do a coach's corner. And of course, we'll have analysis from our Hub Network commentary team and then Coach Morgan, and he might bring in some other athletes. And we're kind of going to zoom that in. We're going to do it a little different than we've done before. Technology's changed a little bit, and we're trying to keep up with that. So that'll be interesting as that develops and goes on. So there's a lot more on the horizon for what we're doing here. So I want you guys to stay tuned. We're going to be talking with Emily Moore here in just a minute about all this easy stuff she's been doing down at the high school. It's very simple and not stressful at all. So we're going to hear about that from Emily here in just a minute. So stay tuned here on the Studio Show. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back.
The Studio Show is brought to you in part by Stillwater Transfer and Storage and AAA Self Storage.
At Davis Dental Studio, our patients are our friends. Unlike the big commercial facilities, Davis Dental Studios wants you to know you're not just a number. We strive to bring personal and quality service to each patient. Dr. Rebecca Davis has over 18 years of experience as a caring and compassionate dentist. She and her highly trained staff will make sure your visit is a positive one. So remember, when you and your family need dental care, Davis Dental Studio. You're not just a patient, you're a friend.
In my mind, I was never going to walk right again. Before we were through, we had walked 23 steps. And that was my first steps of freedom. This patient is saying thank you.
Bank of Cushing, a branch of Blue Sky Bank Mahuska, wants you to know they are still the same friendly hometown bank. Local people that live, work, and worship right here in Cushing. Providing you the same great service, more convenient products and technology, making your local banking experience even better. A great bank, serving a great community. Bank of Cushing, a branch of Blue Sky Bank, Pahuska.
Since 2003, Pro Events has had one singular focus, great audio, video, and lighting systems. Never confusing our industry with the PC crowd, Pro Events always provides you with the best, most reliable options for your house of worship, school, or corporate training facility. Make your system stand out from the crowd. And remember,
for the best AV, you know where to go visit proevents.pro.
The Cushing High School Drama Department presents Mamma Mia, a musical three-act play with stunning choreography and vocal performances by Whitney Wood, Rebecca Beasley, Caden Kennedy, Gloria Selfridge, Lenny Biddle, T.J. Jenkins, Andrew Crum, Dawson Claxton, and many more. Choreography by Becky Jackson, musical director Belinda Flynn, and directed by CHS Drama Department instructor Emily Moore. Come see the CHS Drama Department perform Mamma Mia, April 28th and 29th at 7 p.m., and matinee performances on April 29th at 1 p.m., and Sunday, April 30th at 2 p.m. Come see the CHS Drama Department perform Mamma Mia at the Dura Hobbs Performing Arts Center on the CHS campus.
This is always a problem with this show, is that we're sitting here talking during the commercials, and then it's over and we're still talking. And
yes.
So it's hard. So, all right, in studio with us is Miss Emily Moore. Hey,
Hi. Hey,
Emily, how are you doing?
Hi, I'm great. How are you?
Well,
I'm not great. I'm stressed out, and this is a crazy week, but I'm great.
This is, you know, it's been great fun. I've been down there for a couple of nights, obviously, to get some shots and stuff and do a couple other things. And it's been interesting. And I already said, we're not going to talk about that yet. So then what I do, start talking about that. So I'm going to back up.
Okay, back it up.
We're going to introduce Emily Moore because I know Emily very well. We've known each other for a long time.
Yes.
And from a great family, let me just say that.
Thank
Jay
you.
And your whole, all your kids, I mean, Ryder and your girl. I mean, everybody in that family. I tell you, your girls are the spitting image of Carol. I just can't.
So they're loud, they're funny, they're musical, they're... A little bit sweet.
Maybe all of that, because that was your mom. But I'm just saying, they just look. I mean, it's like Shirley Temple-esque. I mean, they're just the cutest kids ever.
Thank you. And, I think so. Okay.
I mean, I'm just saying. Yeah, I'm glad. But it's just they're so articulate. They every time they speak, it's like your mom in a little tiny voice over there, and a little bit. And it's just I'm just so fascinated by it. And they talk so large and so big. Everything is so grand, and everything is.
That's our family. Everything's big. Yeah.
So I did, but tell me about your family and Jay and all the injuries he's incurred.
Oh my gosh! Yes, poor husband. Yes. Yeah, so as I mean, most people know, Jay is coaches here at Cushing High School. He's football coach, track coach, weightlifting coach, and he is majorly helping with this musical. He is our set constructor. I mean, he is our construction crew.
Whether he wants to be or not,
yes. And it's hard for him. He's in the middle of track season. So we've just been kind of building it as we can. So, so Jay, of course, my husband, always willing to do whatever I say, which is as a true husband should. So I love him for that. And then, my kiddos. Ryder is 11, loves to sing, loves to also play football. So he's got the artistic spectrum and the sports spectrum. Smart kid. He's such a smart kid.
He is. Well,
thank you.
I know Denise has him in fifth
grade. Yes, yeah.
And they have a great.
He loves her.
They have a good time. And she says the same thing. Like he comes in with he's such grand. I mean, these things just kind of bubble out of him, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And so he's a true reflection of. You
thank
guys.
You. So my girls too, they're great. Amelia and Nora, they are both in first grade. And they have Miss Neal as their teacher, who they love and who's great. But yes, my kids. So I know a lot of people don't know this about me, but we don't do Facebook. We don't do any kind of internet. We don't have video games at our house. We don't do all of those things.
By the way, you're all over Facebook right now.
Well. I wouldn't know it. I have friends that send me things like, oh, did you see this? Which is great, but we just don't. And so our kids, as a result, are we talk to them all the time, and we're outside, and we're doing things, and they're very physical. And so I think that's probably a result of that, just having to communicate with us constantly and doing what we ask and chores. And
I mean, there's no negative. I mean, you're not disconnected from the world at all.
No.
I mean, so you're an example kind of You're the anti-Facebook, and I don't know how you've lasted this long. I mean, we've been talking about this for years and years and years, and it was like, nope, not on it. I remember having a conversation over at your office one time. You're like, nope, I'm not on Facebook, not going to be, I'm not going to do it. So,
I know.
And you haven't, and that is, I mean, that's...
It's weird. Right? All my students think it's real weird that we're not, you know, I'm not connected. But like I told you the other day, we're not connected and my life is still very fulfilled. So.
Okay, well, you're good. So, you know, you don't need
nothing against people that are, though, you know, because I know I miss a lot. But.
You don't need Facebook unless you need to watch this show.
Yes. Yes. So,
But, yeah, so you kind of live out, you're outside
of town.
Around
the country. Mm-hmm, we are.
So you have, Jay has cattle, you guys do, and you're constantly, I mean, it is a throwback a little bit.
It is.
To the lifestyle you guys live out there.
Yeah, right? It really is. And we live actually on a fifth generation farm. So my great grandparents bought the farm. So we have continued that. And of course, my kids are all, yep, we're going to live here forever. You know, that probably won't happen. But to each their, you know, I want them to do their thing. But of course, Jay likes them. He says, yes, you're staying here forever, you know, and working. But yeah, we have cows. We have tons of land to maintain. There's something to do constantly, you know, always go home, do something.
And you were talking about the chore, just the routine that you guys have, which is a pretty heavy routine because there's a lot of chores to do. There's a lot of things to keep up with. There's all that kind of good stuff. And your kids participate in that?
They absolutely do. Yes. Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. Gate openers and feed trough fillers and hay bale. I mean, they do it all. Yeah.
That's
so
cool.
Yeah, it is. It's fun.
I know, you know, it's just it's kind of refreshing to see that still exists in a world like today because
it's not easy. That's why it's not easy.
We're about as 180 degrees opposite as possibly. I have zero grass.
Zero grass, yes.
Concrete around the building. Mm-hmm. We have no. My son doesn't even know what it's like to cut a yard. I don't think so. But I tell him.
I'm going to get that kid to my house.
You need to. You need to bring him out there and put him on a brush hog or something. happens. But I mean, it's interesting how that. All goes, but
yeah, we're all different, right?
Yeah,
we just do different things.
So what? I mean, obviously, your mother passed away not too long ago. I don't want to bring up too many things, but she was, I mean, a real staple and pillar at the community theater. Directed for years and years and years and years.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about your experience at the community theater and what that was like with her.
Sure.
And your dad being so involved down there.
Yes, yeah, because my dad was too.
Absolutely.
So yeah, my mom co-founded it with Barbara Lear when I was like 6 years old. And we actually did the first production. Well, maybe not the first, but my first production was in the basement of the library.
Oh, wow.
And it was Chicken Little. And so I remember that vividly. And I tell my students that I'm like, I sang, "Oh my, the sky is falling." And that was my big moment. And I was so proud of it. So I remember it to this day, on the little bitty stage down there. So that's where it began. And then of course it evolved over time and they got the building. And then now we have the blessing that we have now, which is this awesome place to downtown to perform and utilize. And, I know there's been several that have kind of stepped in and taken charge, and I think that's awesome. And so, yeah, we did lots of plays there. I mean, I grew up there kind of and was there a lot. Went away to school, but came back and, of course, got right back in. And I never directed. I never did, like we were talking about, I never did lighting. I never, you know, that was sort of like, oh, there's someone that does that because I'm just an actress, right? So, as most actresses are. So I kind of came in and did my thing. So I'm definitely learning a lot more now and appreciating my mom now that I didn't before, but there's a lot more
to it. Well, a lot of that goes to show you just how difficult some of those productions are.
Oh my gosh.
Even at a community theater, it's all volunteer work.
You
don't have the infrastructure of other students or other teachers or other people to help you.
Absolutely.
That, you know, that you can kind of whip them into.
That you can voluntold. I was told they're voluntold to do things. You don't have that. It's just, oh, who can help? Great. One. Great. We'll take you.
Right,
you know,
right.
So yeah.
You work. I don't know anything about lighting. Great. You're all right.
Great. You're light. Yes,
so,
exactly.
Yeah. So that's how it goes. But so much of that had gone on. And you talk about the building being over there. I mean, you guys used to move around.
Yeah.
And do productions in different locations, which was four times harder.
The old Escott, what's Dollar General now downtown, that was vacant for a while. They used that, but thanks to Harry Escott, they used the lower elementary. What is now the lower elementary? Harmony. They used that stage some. I mean, they did it in the park. I mean, it's just, it was very like a traveling kind of a thing for a while.
And so then when you talk about the blessing of having one place, now you can store all your props and all that stuff down there. So that is a huge benefit to the community, and it's been something that
it is.
You guys, your family has spent many, many, many hours down developing. And
which I have to say, as it has changed, you know, like Michelle right now, Music, who is in charge of it, overly awesome to me. I mean, as my, you know, because of knowing the history. And so Anytime I call her and need anything, absolutely, absolutely. I mean, she just is a yes kind of gal. So yeah. I appreciate her tremendously, just recognizing that and just, you know, being loyal to that. It's really cool.
Well, and that's, I mean, that is kind of a result of the legacy that was kind of left with Carol and Debbie.
And Ryan, Debbie, and Walter. Yes, absolutely.
And all those people that have spent a lot of time, countless hours, for just, and it seems like, sometimes in the business I'm in too, in the production business, you're like, you do all that work for 2 hours worth of, and people, they kind of say it like that. Well, yeah, we do, but there has to be people to do that, because if you don't have people, then there's no 2 hours of whatever.
Yeah,
And it's a long, it's a lot, big commitment for people to be parts of productions. It's big commitment for people to learn all the lines.
It is, but it's also life-changing, because I have seen people, you know, that wouldn't normally do things. And then that helps them in their actual life, you know, be more outgoing or whatever it might be, or build friendships. Absolutely. And so there's so much more that goes into it than just a show, right? I mean, there's all these relationships and fundamentals that get built along the way.
It doesn't take long to get a few community theater actors in the same room before you're going back to...
Last night. We did it last night.
You're hearing lines from, scenes from, and things that people remember. It's a lot of fun.
It is. And you hold those with you for life. It's just so neat. Such a neat time.
It's a real connection. I would even talk about maybe John Alcorn is one person that I saw. Somebody that was, talk about in a shell, that nobody
just
knew
quiet,
very much
and
about.
Yeah.
Was quiet, unassuming.
Yes.
And then he shows up and you put him on stage. And I remember your mom saying, oh my gosh, this kid can act. I mean, he all of a sudden just came out and boom, there he was. And tell him, know your lines. He knew his lines. He knew where to be. He knew all this stuff.
Very dependable.
And you found out about this guy that you wouldn't even think could even know where a stage was controlling the stage. He was,
he was one of those too that, like, you know, you come in and you're unsure, and then you get like assigned one thing, and you're like, oh, okay, he's a yes guy. He'll do whatever we say, right?
Yeah,
so then you get assigned, and then you're going, oh my gosh. But he did it so well. And then, you know, again, another like story of creating fundamentals in life and having experiences.
It absolutely is. And he's done a few commercials for us in the past too, just, you know, back in the old days of the Cushing Hub. And you know, he was kind of our faux spokesperson.
Right,
but
yes.
Had him. But I mean, you can just tell him one time, and he's like, boom, and he's just right there on it. So he's really, really good.
Yeah,
but those are the kind of things. The other thing I have to bring up, I'd probably get in trouble if I didn't bring it up.
What?
Is that, you know, we go back a ways, and I want to give you because you're still like, 25?
Yeah, super.
25,
super good.
23, 25.
I tell my students I'm an old lady all the time. Yeah, it's okay.
But you've got a kid in your, my kid, in your production this year.
I do.
He's 17, going to be 18.
So crazy.
And you and Denise, my wife, were on stage at the time we announced his birth.
Or I may be speaking out, but like, I'm pretty sure I was one of the first people to know about Caden's existence.
We're
clear. Not to offend any family members, but sure I was important.
Because it was announced on the community theater stage
that
Denise was pregnant with Caden, so that was a big... That was a big deal for my mother-in-law. And
that was so cool. Such a cool moment, yeah.
So that's something that Caden will always be,
Yes.
I mean, you know, it's a cool connection, right?
Absolutely.
And so from that day all the way on, I mean, even before that, we were palling around at the community theater.
Oh, yeah.
But I mean, it's
just for
cool
me to have that experience, knowing that, like, you guys that were just going to have him announce it, and then now I have him in a play. That's so cool.
Yeah,
And he's a great kid, by the way.
Well, we hope so, but but he's, hopefully he doesn't crash and burn. No, we don't think he's going to do well. But all the kids, we're going to talk about that too.
Okay.
A little bit. All those kids are really,
they're awesome.
They are all
awesome.
I've been around you a long time, and I know how this kind of works and evolves, and what you're trying to do to pique everything. We're going to talk about that. You're drawing me into it.
I'm off script.
But I'm going to just tell you, you're going to want to see these kids and these productions, because they're not, some of these kids are going to be gone from Cushing High School and Cushing after a while and be off to college and not be here. And there's a lot of talent down there.
There is.
And we're going to talk about that later, too.
Absolutely
right. Well, we talked about your film. We got number one off the list.
Okay, good. Check that out.
So we're going to come back to number two here in just a minute. We'll take a quick commercial break, and we'll come back and reset here a little bit and talk about how you even got into this position.
Oh,
we'll get ask you some good questions, you know, qualifications.
Right.
You know, whatever.
Does she have any?
she does have. We'll be right back here in just a minute.
Okay.
We'll be right back.
The Studio Show is brought to you in part by Stillwater Transfer and Storage and AAA Self Storage.
Well, hello, Whitney.
Hello, John. So here's the proposal packet for the new mobile app.
As long as I'm running this thing, there ain't gonna be no mobile app.
Introducing the new mobile app, making your banking experience even easier. It's so easy, even John can use it. Bank of Cushing, a branch of Blue Sky Bank, Pawhuska.
We have a help tab if you need help. We will have...
I don't need help. I'm pretty good at this.
You are good at this.
The Cushing High School Drama Department presents Mamma Mia! A musical three-act play with stunning choreography and vocal performances by Whitney Wood, Rebecca Beasley, Caden Kennedy, Gloria Selfridge, Lenny Biddle, T.J. Jenkins, Andrew Crum, Dawson Claxton, and many more. Choreography by Becky Jackson, musical director Belinda Flynn, and directed by CHS Drama Department instructor Emily Moore. Come see the CHS Drama Department perform Mamma Mia, April 28th and 29th at 7 p.m. and matinee performances on April 29th at 1 p.m. and Sunday, April 30th at 2 p.m. Come see the CHS Drama Department perform Mamma Mia at the Dura Hobbs Performing Arts Center on the CHS campus.
Since 2003, Pro Events has had one singular focus: great audio, video, and lighting systems. Never confusing our industry with the PC crowd, Pro Events always provides you with the best, most reliable options for your house of worship, school, or corporate training facility. Make your system stand out from the crowd. And remember,
for the best AV, you know where to go. Visit proevents.pro.
When you have a team of physicians and nurses that really truly care about their patients, that translates into patient care.
It's a small practice, it's a small town. Everybody really takes that time to put the patient first.
Everybody cares what's happening to me and that I'm making progress and I'm gaining my freedom back and my mobility back. This patient is saying thank you.
At Davis Dental Studio, our patients are our friends. Unlike the big commercial facilities, Davis Dental Studios wants you to know you're not just a number. We strive to bring personal and quality service to each patient. Dr. Rebecca Davis has over 18 years of experience as a caring and compassionate dentist. She and her highly trained staff will make sure your visit is a positive one. So remember, when you and your family need dental care, Davis Dental Studio. You're not just a patient, you're a friend.
RCB Bank is more than a transaction. We work to make your life easier. We help build your business. We finance your dreams. We grow your legacy. We build relationships with our communities. Come in to find out why our customers always say, RCB Bank, that's my bank.
And there I did it again. We were talking about it. It was a very interesting story.
Sorry,
I
wish
I
could. Sorry.
I think what I should do on this show is simply record the in-between commercials, because the conversations we have during those commercials are sometimes better than whatever you talk about on the show. Now, in this case, that's not the truth, but no. You know, if you got a dog with an eyeball hanging out, I mean, I'm just saying. That's a pretty good story.
You know, ask me sometime. Ask me sometime. Yeah,
the conversation story.
Don't ask me on Facebook. Just call me. Call me or text me.
Conversation with Emily Moore, an icebreaker right there. If you ask her about the dog with his eye hanging out. Yeah. All right. Okay. So now, how long have you, this is your first year.
Very first year teaching. Yes.
Teaching.
Like ever. Not just here, like ever. First year teaching ever.
And so what in the world possessed you to think that this is going to be good?
Jay Moore.
Jay Moore.
It is all his fault. And I letting know that constantly.
Gotcha.
So I worked in my dad's law office, of course, for like 20 years. And then he decided to retire right about the time COVID hit, which was great. So I was home, you know, with my kiddos, loved being home, being able to go to all the parties at school and just be the, you know, this great, amazing mom that just goes and does it all.
Right.
And so, not that I did, but that's, you know, what the role was. That's the role I was playing.
That's what you were doing.
Exactly. Exactly. So then then it was time to like, okay, maybe I should probably go back to work somewhere. So what am I going to do? What am I going to do? Discussion. And this position happened to come up. And my mom was kind of getting a little sicker at that time. Right. So that was heavy on my mind. And then this job position came open, and Jay just said, I remember he called me and he goes, "You're never going to believe what job came open, and I think this is perfect." And I said, "What are you talking about? I don't teach." Like, and he's been wanting me to be a teacher forever just to have the same schedule.
Yeah, yeah.
But I just was like, I just don't think I'd be good at it. I don't think it's my thing. Like, and so long story short, I emailed Mr. Coates and I said, "Hey, you know, I understand this position's open and I'm interested. I realize you might have more qualified people, but if you just want to talk about it, that'd be great." And so he got back with me, and then I met with he and Dr. Amen, and they were just like, "We think this would be really good." And so I said, "I mean, I'm unqualified in the way that, do I have a teaching degree? No. And am I qualified? You know, am I certified in drama? No. But again, like we've discussed, lifetime of experience, which sometimes kind of, you know, weighs in there too." And so they were very gracious about, you know, I said, "I'm going to need help because I'm not going to know what I'm doing, I feel like." And I will say Nancy Billingsley, who used to teach at the high school and is now out at the administration building, instrumental in helping me and just giving me confidence along the way and encouraging me and always being a good ear. Like, I cannot give her props enough because she's amazing. And so I owe a lot to her. But yeah, just that's just how it came about.
What?
It just was like a, hey, maybe. And then, oh my gosh. And then literally on my birthday, they called me and said, "Okay." And we went off and I said, "Oh my gosh, I feel like this is kismet. It's my birthday. I should take the job."
There you go.
Oh, I did.
Well, I mean, listen, I don't know of anybody better because to know what it takes to put that stuff on. I mean, listen, you might be an excellent teacher. You might be this and that, but to have the whole, you may not have the teaching degree yet.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Right. Yeah. Right. Yes.
But what
I do have a degree. Let's be clear. I have a degree in business. I did graduate from college.
Right. That's good. But
yeah.
You did act your way through college.
Yes.
But let me just. But when it comes to drama though, and putting that stuff on, my goodness, I mean, the amount of experience you bring into that job is quite extensive. I mean,
thank you.
There's just no question about that. So I can't think. Yeah. I can't think of anybody better. And I'll be honest with you. Just looking
that.
At, and I know it's probably stressful your first year. You've taken on a pretty big production for your first year too.
Yes.
And. In a large cast.
Yes.
That's complicated because, you know, there's costumes, there's wardrobe, there's set, I mean, all that stuff, lines.
Right.
And it's a musical, which is another complicated
27 songs in this sucker.
Yeah.
27 songs. I just want to make that clear.
So you've proven that you're a glutton for punishment, right?
Yeah, exactly. I just love it.
So there's no question about that. But I'm just telling you, you're bringing all that experience to bear. And it shows because it's easy to sit down there and watch just little bits of it. I haven't even seen in total at all, but just parts of scenes, and to see how the kids have responded to you, and not just the actors. We're talking about people off stage, you know, that are working behind the scenes.
Yes.
You know, obviously, you know, people in line. You now, let's. We're gonna. I'm gonna go back into talking about it already, and you're gonna make
I was
me.
Thinking we're
to trying
say
to do it. Okay, but. You brought in a few people to help, which I think is very smart because it is an overwhelming job.
Yes, to say the least.
And you start talking about choreography, and you start talking about musical direction and set construction, and all that stuff that you've talked about. Which
it's like all these different things that you're cramming into one, which is you're huge on their own. Yes.
So choreography. Tell me about Becky Jackson and what you did.
Becky Jackson. I love Becky Jackson. So she is the OSU POM coach and spirit coordinator at OSU. She's fantastic. She was on the POM squad for OSU for a few years, and I should know. I think it was four, but I should know that I don't. But awesome, talented, amazing, loving, caring person. She was also a teacher for a little while, and then now does the POM stuff and the spirit coordinator stuff full time. So she's got that kind of experience, which is great. And plus, she's just a super talented girl, and she's just happens to be married to my very talented cousin too. So
that's the connection.
Okay.
But that using that resource though, that's but that has paid off because I'll tell you
my gosh.
Now, in the promo, we're going to talk about all the problems with my promo, because we were kind of piecing that together as we were going. Yeah, there are lots of them, so you know, we're going to expose all those today. So stick around. But part of that is that you don't really get to see much choreography in there yet,
right,
because it was still in development.
Yes.
But I'll just tell you right now, there's a lot.
A lot.
And you don't, that doesn't represent it very well in the promo, but man.
But there had to be, because this is such a, like, the music is so fun and it's so vibrant. I mean, there's some, you know, love too, but the music is so fun and vibrant. You can't just stand there. You have to move. And so, but a lot of these kids are not just natural. I mean, a lot of us aren't natural dancers, you know, or beat keepers or whatever. So Becky did a phenomenal job. And I just, we were doing this, I said, I know exactly who I want for this, because she's related to me. So I know she'll say yes.
But Jackson, your mother's brother?
Yes, my mother's, brother's, yeah.
And is she related to him then? I guess.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. So she's married to my cousin, Brandon, who has been in bands and super talented guy, too, and also works for OSU. But so that's how I roped her in. And
Brandon Jackson.
Brandon, yes.
Yeah, okay. Brandon, yeah, I got you.
So, yeah, he's actually played and done stuff for the community theater before, as well as, I mean, all over. I mean, he's pretty big time.
Yeah, we've done shows for him.
Yeah, he's great. I was like, I've got to have her. So I called her on the phone. And, I mean, you're talking about a person who, like, organizes events for OSU, which is constant. It never stops.
It never stops.
And it's overlapping. And it's, you know, this and basketball. I mean, it's just constant.
Yeah.
And so I thought, I hate to ask her this, but I'm going to ask her this. Yeah. And so I didn't hesitate. I mean, immediately she's like, absolutely. I would love to do
this.
Awesome. This would be so fun. I can't wait. Let's tell me when, you know, so.
Man, well, but that.
Lucky to have
that expertise in that area. You know, it's not just the normal, you know, because a lot, and I'm not, I'm just saying, sometimes you have to use what's available to you in some of these other productions, and that's fine.
Absolutely.
But it's just a notch or two above what you normally get, because it's really good.
And it's creative, it's just the creativity
that's
of
the
it.
Part of it.
Because I could, I mean, I can tell you to go like this and go over here, but the creativeness of it was real cool to watch her do.
Telling a story through the choreography, I mean, that's a different skill.
Yes, and again, these really kids aren't dancers, and so to do it in a way where she's used to dealing with, like, they know what they're doing, to, like, we really want to, but we're not sure. And she did a great job. And these kids, I mean, I couldn't believe what she did with them. I mean, really, not that I didn't think they could, but I was super impressed. And they stepped up to the plate hugely on choreography.
It's the same thing that we've seen kind of pulling the best out of the kids. The same result that she got there.
Yes.
That because of the approach was the same. And so, and I just think that is going to shine through in this whole production, because, you know, it's one thing to say it in a promo to get you to buy a ticket and come,
right,
but really you need to come see it, because
it's
these
so
kids
good.
Are doing some things that are
little, they're phenomenal.
Yeah, it is.
I mean, they really are. They're phenomenal.
There's really no other way to say it, and it really doesn't do justice to it to even say those words.
Yeah.
But
they're so good. Come see it. They're so good. I can't tell you how much they're just so good.
It's absolutely a good job. Absolutely. And to hear, you know, now we both know, you and I know, it's tough to get a good compliment, and you never really get a great compliment out of Don.
Who are you talking about? I can't imagine.
Out of Don, because he has such an extensive theatrical background.
Exactly.
I told him that.
I was like, I know you have 90 years worth of experience, you know. But
I said last night, it's so funny because Dawson is a lot, in some respects, a little bit like Don in some respects.
Yeah.
And so Dawson came out in the scene and decided to put on some glasses, and you were like, what? You're sitting at the back, and you're like, what do you have on your face? All of a sudden, you can't see, you can't read. What is the problem? You have glasses on. You can't do that in the middle of a play.
Just decide to wear glasses.
And I said, well, you know, if that would have been Don, he would have reblocked the whole scene because he decided to put on glasses. He would have made everybody stop.
Uh-huh.
And now everybody has to see
He doesn't
glasses.
Change. We all change. Yes, exactly.
To adapt to his eyeglasses. You know,
Adapt to the bit.
It was just kind of funny to see it.
But it was funny.
But it's those kind of things that make it diverse and interesting. But in that, some people might say, oh, that's a problem. You know, or, no, it's not a problem, because Dawson is still developing his character.
Here we are
in the week of the show, and he is still developing his character.
Absolutely.
Getting it in his head, what he's going to do and how he's going to do it. And then to see it just kind of evolve, that's always the cool thing, right?
Yeah.
So, but I don't know, that you have a very good command of that. And you simply told him, we can't wear
glasses. Yeah, I said, why is he wearing them? He said, I don't know, just tried it. And I said, nope, he's not, nope, we're not doing any. Okay, you know, and it was done. That was it.
It was it. But it was, it's good, though. It's good to see that kind of interaction between the director and the cast, and them understanding what their character is. I think that tells you a lot.
Right. And because I'm new, and because I mean, you had asked me, and I actually lied to you yesterday. I'm gonna admit it.
Okay.
You said, have you ever directed before? And I said, no, but that's not true, because my first one was a one-act play that we did, and it got pushed, and we didn't do it till January. But that was my very first, and it was great, and I loved it, and they did great. And a lot of them, it was their first production, too, but I learned a lot. And so this is monumentally larger, than that. And so just because of the personnel and everything that's involved. So this is my first musical to direct, and it is massive, and I'm learning a lot. And that being said, I take their notes. I want to hear their input, and I don't, yes, I might change it and not say, nope, that's not the vision, but I always welcome them to like make comments and give me their opinions, because it's their production, not mine, So I want their input, and I want to be on the same page as them.
And I think that's kind of what I see, and I'm just going to, we could spend a whole other show on this stuff, because if I get off onto this, but I'll just tell you, what I saw Carol do all those years is take, and some of those shows were written by them.
Yes, yeah.
And so there's nothing to go look at, there's nothing to go see, this is how this character is.
Right.
But they would cast characters, and then as they developed, they kind of changed it to work it into, to develop that character even more. And this is what this character would do. And so we changed.
I mean,
you just watch that evolution.
Right.
And that's a very
together. It was a very collaborative.
That's a very different way to get that to come out of people.
Yes.
Than to go the very strict. I mean, you can do it both ways.
Yeah.
I'm not saying there's anything wrong with that.
Right.
But it's just interesting to see how you've kind of done that the same way with a very structured. It's a very, you have to do things very specifically for the rights.
Yes, you do.
So you have to, within the confines of that, but still, there's a lot of development going on between you and the characters on stage. Is
that right? Right. So early on, I took some of the students to a UCO drama day, which they put on, which is awesome, and I hope to do more of those things. But one of the things that I asked the actors, because there's a lot of stuff that happens on stage, and as a person that's watched a lot, I pay attention to the little things.
Uh-huh.
And so there was a couple bits, that happened, and I asked the director, I said, okay, they had a question and answer session for the kids, and I couldn't help it. I was like, okay, so these little things that happened, was that the actors or was that you? And it was most definitely the actors. I mean, he allowed them that little bit of creativity, which... Again, it's so important, because as an actor, you want to be who you want to be, right? But your director has a vision, and does that always mesh? And so there's lots to think about with that.
Absolutely.
But I think it's always good to collaborate at least a little bit. Now, granted, there's some things like the glasses. I'm like, nope, and that's fine.
Right.
But other than that, I do. I've listened to them a lot and taken a lot of their input.
I think it's interesting. So there's the part of the process that you go through. I don't think people understand that. So at the end of a scene, you'll do, okay, everybody, notes. We're going to do notes.
Yes.
And so you come from the back. You've been watching them go through it.
Right.
And you're writing down. You're not interrupting what's going on. You're trying to let them have some continuity and get fluid with
it. Yes, because you don't want to interrupt the scene all the time, especially as it gets closer and closer. They've got to figure it out.
So you can't just make corrections right there. You've got to let them kind of develop it. So, but then you say notes, and everybody comes down to the front of the stage. Now, I just think this is interesting to watch the interaction between the director and the cast. Do you have their attention? Are they paying attention? Are they bought in?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this is where...
Are they in? Are they out? Are they in? Are they out?
Exactly.
Yeah.
So if you're a football coach, right, when you're calling the plays, they know what to do. You can see the light in their eyes, right?
Yes.
You can see if they know what they're going to do, if it's going to be successful, if they know why they're doing it.
Right.
If you know the story behind it. So you can see a lot. You can glean a lot from the interaction between when you're reading these notes and what they're doing. Because if they're paying attention to you, then they're asking, oh, so... When I do this, and you,
you
can see the light bulbs go off with the vision that you have for it and what they're doing, what they physically have to do. It's a very different thing to be on stage.
It is.
And to project yourself out.
Because
we're just watching.
It's a very vulnerable position.
Yeah, it is, because you're just watching it out of here, but it's a very different thing to project over the top.
Yes.
What you have to get to convey in your body language and the
everything.
Character, all
yes.
that stuff. So... I just think that that interaction tells me a lot, that they're bought in. They are completely bought into what your vision is of this production.
Thank you. I hope so. They seem like they are. They're enjoying it.
Because I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why. Because just like you said, that like when you and Jay, you wouldn't go to the movie, you would simply go over to your Carol and Bill's house and just watch the show. You said they always put on a show.
Yeah.
I'm just telling you, when you're doing notes, you're acting out the play, you watch the play right there. You're doing every part. You're doing it, and you're showing them exactly how to project the body language. Mm-hmm. So you, I can see that in a few times we're down there. So I think that's a very effective. It's not very effective. It is super effective because when you're developing people that haven't done acting, haven't done a lot of acting, haven't been on stage a lot,
it's uncomfortable for them.
They need to see the bigness of it. They need to see it's okay to do that.
Be a little
say
silly
that,
or be, whatever. Or be bigger.
I mean, I just think, man, I don't know how many times I've heard your mom say that. Just be bigger. Just
be bigger. Be bigger.
You can't be big enough. Now,
yes.
You can be maybe.
Well, right. And Dr. Amon said that to them the other night. He said, you can always go big. You can always scale it back. But you like once you hit that, then, I mean, that's it. So,
So that's
so start there, and then you can.
It's cool because there's some very. I'll just take we'll take Dawson and Becca, and some of those kids that have done a lot of play production. Mm-hmm. Of course, they don't have much of a problem coming out of their shell a little bit.
Sure.
But to see them embrace that, I mean, you get to watch that the whole time. That's pretty cool.
It's very cool. And it's fun to watch the whole the kind of morphing of the characters as it goes from we started this in February beginning middle of February, and so to watch it go from you're reading a line on a script to then now we're sort of on stage but we're still kind of mousy to here we are singing this song. I mean, it's such a cool progression to just witness. Right. And so I have to say you're gonna get a great show, but I get the best show because I get to watch all of that growth, and it's unbelievable.
It's always what I liked about I would spend time just going over to the community theater, sitting next to your mom, watching her direct, watching them develop. It's the best part
of
the show.
So
you see
cool.
the end result. Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
Boy, if you could have seen the whole thing, it was really interesting.
Yeah.
We can't talk about that too long. We got to move on.
I know. Okay.
So, but let's talk about who's doing your lighting? Let's talk.
Well, first, can we talk about I'm not doing this by myself.
Absolutely.
Okay. Becky Jackson, awesome choreography. That's her jam. She has come in and done an amazing job. Belinda Flynn, who is the musical portion of this entire thing. She is in charge of helping them learn their songs and knowing when to do this and
harmonies.
All their tone and the harmonies. And so that's her, and she has done a phenomenal. She is awesome. She's just a fun person to be around
absolutely.
In general. I love her to pieces, and I knew her but didn't know her like I know her now, and oh my gosh, amazing individual.
Absolutely.
I love her, and she does, I mean, it would not be what it is
it's
without her.
It's a good quality program that she has anyway. And her command of that.
Yes.
In a musical sense is always very good.
Yes. So. And again, those students, they listen to her. They know exactly what she expects. I mean, it's awesome to watch that. So she is a humongous part of this. And then more recently, we've had Miss Arnold, who is the accompanist for Miss Flynn and her choir and her music, has kind of taken charge backstage with my stage crew because she does that professionally. I mean, for the Tulsa Performing Arts Center. So I've got some pretty big, names and people that are helping me out. So I want to be clear that I'm not taking credit for all of this because it is definitely a creative collaboration that is making this all possible and making it look so good.
Yes. But let me just say, some directors don't like that too much. But I'm just saying, from your experience though, and your background,
right.
It's exactly what you want, right?
Right.
Because it's so hard to come by in a community theater sense. Right?
Yes.
And to get that level of expertise and that level of interest and buy-in, even from the other people that are working with you to produce this, is huge.
Yes, it is. So, and originally, I don't know if you want to talk about this yet, so cut me off if
go
you
ahead,
don't.
No,
but,
we're
when I first became a teacher, I had a new teacher's meeting, right? And so I come in and I'm uncomfortable because I've been around a long time, but I don't know everyone. And then
you've been around what?
A long time.
A long time.
Yeah, just a long time. A little bit of time. Right. But to come in, I feel like a little bit of a fraud, right? Because I'm not a teacher and I don't, have this experience that they do. And so I came in a little meek, but everyone's so welcoming, so nice, so loving. And Miss Flynn, right out the gate, looks at me as Miss Flynn can and says, "So, okay, you're the new drama teacher." And I said, I'm excited, I'm nervous. And she goes, "Well, we're supposed to do a musical this year." And I said, "Well, then let's do a musical this year, So that's where so she said, "I was already promised," because she was excited.
Yeah.
And I said, "Well, I am on board because that's my jam anyway. I love musicals."
Right.
So that is where that kind of just, okay, that's what we're doing.
Yeah.
So she
didn't really know what to expect.
She didn't. Yeah, because like I said, I had known her and she's been sleeping with my kids, but we didn't know professionally each other. And so now I have massive respect for her.
Absolutely.
And I hope she has respect for me. We'll see.
Oh, I think so. I think I can just tell you from being, because, sometimes I can kind of infiltrate the crew back
there. You're perfect.
I get to hear some of that a little bit. But no, I can tell you that I think it's all the way around. And if it wasn't that way, you wouldn't be seeing the results you're seeing.
Absolutely. There.
And so I think, you know, with Don doing what he does, which is all, he's always a, just Don being around a production is always fun.
Oh, yeah.
No matter what he's doing, he's kind of running audio and doing all that stuff. And did a really good job at that, by the way, which is not an easy job.
No, it isn't.
I'll just tell you, that's not always easy. And so, Miss Flynn.
And Miss Arnold, I forgot to say this, but she was the drama teacher at Stroud for like the last, I should know how long, but it's been a while, you know. I mean, she's very young. I don't want to say that she's, you know, but like has done that for years, and that was her thing. So lots of experience with, and so she's given me some notes too, which is great. I mean, like I said, it's a collaborative effort anyways, actors, helpers, anything. So I always enjoy like getting a little tidbits of information and knowledge, you know? Yes. And then lighting, we have, Kinsey Terrell, who's a sophomore at CHS. Okay. She helped me with the first place. Kinsey is in my drama one class this year. And so got to know her very well. Super responsible. One of those kids that you go, I wish I had five more of you because I would put you in charge of this, you know. Yeah. So immediately, whatever you need, you know, and so she's interested in the lighting. And so now she's developed, gone from like, sure, I can learn that, to now she can like tweak it and look and I can say, I want, you know, more of this, and she can totally do that. So awesome for her. Yeah. So I love, she's great. I can depend on her. I don't have to worry. And then, of course, Dr. Amon's doing our sound for us, which is huge, because sound is a huge part of this musical. Now it has to be on.
We talked a little bit about the set construction, but let me just, let's just talk about the art teacher.
Oh, yes. Yeah.
Who has done so much to get that all pulled together and to make it look like.
Right.
Now, in the promos, again, you don't see finished, you see kind of what it looked like, but you don't really
see. But that's
see
not what it. That was just a sneak peek. And we do that on purpose. I do that on purpose.
Yes, because when you get the first reveal of that,
yes,
when the curtain opens, that's going to be, that will itself be stunning.
Yes, I hope so. So my mom was always a big believer in that when you open those doors, right, because the theater downtown didn't have a curtain to close.
Right.
So it was always, don't let them in, don't let them in. And then when you open, it's like, oh, they took it all in, right? And there was that moment of, oh my gosh, this is amazing. So that's what I always
want to.
Sets
the mood for the
rest of the production. So I don't like any pictures taken of the final set. And I don't like anything out that's the final, because I want that to be such an, oh my gosh, moment.
Right.
Which gets me emotional because my mom was that way.
Well,
sorry.
I wasn't trying to do
that. No, that's okay. But the set is phenomenal. Jay and I constructed it. We had some kids helping us too. It wasn't just all us. Miss Myers, I approached her and said, okay, which she is a new teacher. She just graduated in December and started here in January. Yes. So she's super new. And I said, hey, you want to do this big project for me and with me? Sure you do, right? So, but again, another person who was like, oh my gosh, I've never done this before, but sure, I'll jump in and try my best. And her best is pretty awesome. I'm just gonna tell you, like, she has been cool about coming in after school or working with me on hours and just really like, if I say, this is kind of what I'm thinking, she's just great about executing it.
Well, what she started with and what she has now. Now I'm sure she's still
down there working today. Like, we're still finishing up things today, you know?
I'm telling you, it's transformed itself since I was really even taking some of these pictures, which was last week. In just a week's time, that has gone from to wow.
Yeah, thank you.
So, I mean, in the colors, it's just, in all of it, the lighting, which accents the colors of the stage, which, you know, is all good. And so those are big, small things, but they're big impact things when you talk about the whole production.
Absolutely. And you know, Jay, I have to talk about Jay constructing. So, of course, when we were doing things downtown, he had a lot of, he was always down there constructing sets. You know, and we have our favorites. Oh, my gosh, remember we did this and that. So he's had a lot of experience building because he was always my mom's go-to of construction, you know. So, so anyways.
You get to paint a lot of things. You know. And set construction is not different. It's different than just normal carpentry. Right?
It takes
a few different skills.
It does.
And so these are it's all
a thought.
Things.
A lot of thought and a lot of math, which I'm not a math person. That's why I'm not a math teacher. So, I'm like, okay, I'm glad you're here because I couldn't have figured that out. So my kids that were helping me, I'd be like, okay, who's good at math? Who's good at math? Raise a hand. We need your skills.
And that's the whole part of the big picture for a director too is all of that buy-in. It has not just from the kids, just from the, you know, in this case, the school who has to kind of...
Which is huge too. That's another part
fund of it. And get everybody together and kind of give you the carte blanche here. This is what you need to do and this is how you have to do it and all that stuff and get behind you.
Yes.
So you have all of that and all the staff there that is helping that all the way around. And so it's when you talk about a monumental undertaking, it's a lot different than just a community theater production.
Yeah,
I mean, it's a bigger monster, I guess.
Yes, yeah. even in my the first one we did in January, it was very, I picked the play itself because AI was new and it was very minimal set, minimal stuff that was going on, just the storyline of it. And so I thought, thank goodness, because I'm not ready for anything big. But then, of course, this is huge. So yeah, there is just a lot to it. And then we had a scheduling conflict and had to take our set, after we constructed it, had to take it all down and then rebuild it again. So that was lessons learned. Like, I take notes on everything that I'm doing. So, you know, and that stuff happens because it's a community place. And so, you know, it's not just us that's up there using it. Like, whereas at the theater, you build and nobody else is going to be down there. You know, you have it. Right. But at the school, it's a school, you know, and so it's everybody uses it, you know, for elementary programs or whatever. So working around all of that and scheduling is huge, too. Absolutely. It's a big part of it. And you talked about the school. I want to talk about the school because originally we had kind of had a conversation about this. This musical is a little it's a little controversial. There's
a little edgy. On the plot of the show. Let's talk about that.
Yes. Okay. So originally, Miss Flynn had thrown around another musical, and I just wasn't on board with this musical. I just thought, man, I just want to do something more fun. And I mean, I like the other one, and I'm not going to say it because we might do it at some point. But I thought, gosh, I'm just not really into that. And the kids, it was just kind of a vibe. So then when Miss Flynn and I kind of sat down to really look at musicals and what we might want, I said, I'm just not really into that one. That, you know, and she's like, okay, well, let's think about others. And I said, well, like, what would you want to do? And she said, oh, well, I'd love to do Mamma Mia, but I don't think that'll happen. And I said, why? And she said, because it's too edgy. And I said, well, let's find out. So we just said, hey, let's just ask. It doesn't hurt to ask. So that just blossomed from there. And that went to Dr. Amon and Mr. Coates, who then had discussions with us and themselves and agreed to send it on to the board, who then had their, and then everybody was like, sure, it's going to be fine. This is going to be great and wonderful for these kids. And the kids were pumped about it.
Well, and here's the thing. So the storyline, and we can talk a little bit about that.
A little bit.
If you know the story of Mamma Mia, it's a little bit edgy in the sense that it's not always the way, it's not the perfect life.
Right.
Trajectory or the plan that you want
to be on. Her family or whatever.
Things didn't work out quite the right way.
Right.
And so
it is not a cookie cutter script. A cookie cutter story.
White picket fence and all that. So, but when you want, and I just got this from the other night, really last night watching it, is most I'd seen the most continuity of the whole thing seen. And it was just half of it. But you didn't really get that in the play. That didn't come through. What came through was the musical ability, the script, the plot.
Sure.
That's all the background, but it wasn't edgy. It wasn't performed edgy. It's like fun.
Yes.
Yes, there's that element to it, but it doesn't.
That's not the focus.
It's not the focus.
It's not the focus. And it's funny that you say, okay, the plot, but it's sort of background. It really is sort of background.
It is.
I mean, the story, of course, is like what you're, as an actor, you're telling the story, right? But there's so much more to this. There's so much, and the fact that it's kids doing it and how amazing they are. And so you do kind of, you don't focus on the edgy part of it. It's sort of lost in translation, really. So
you're just watching the performances are so good.
Yes.
You're really focused on that.
They're so good.
Because, I mean, the way they deliver their lines, you're down to some things that you usually don't get to focus on until way down the line in a production. I mean, like after it's over, so way down the line, like, oh, I wish we would have.
So
you're kind of doing that. I wish we would have list now.
Yeah.
And that just tells you how far along you are in the production. And I think that speaks a lot to, one, the direction of the play, and two, the level of buy-in and talent from the kids on stage.
Yes, we have some seriously talented kids who are phenomenal. And then you add in Miss Flynn and Miss Arnold. I mean, and then Dr. Amy. I mean, it's such a well-oiled machine at this time that it's awesome. It's awesome to see. And I am gonna be backstage, but I hate it because I want to sit out there and enjoy it every, like my mom. She used to sit every and then laugh the loudest and clap the loudest, and that's me. I love it so much. I can't stand it. I want to see it all the time.
I said last night it was so reminiscent. I mean, just for the little bit of time that I was there, to hear you react to.
They're so funny.
It's fun to watch that. It's just fun to watch that interaction. And I guarantee you, you'll not want to just come watch this one time. You're going to want to watch
it because
you're going to watch it once and be like, oh, that was good. And you're going to come the next time and go, well, now I could focus on, I kind of know what's going on there, but I can see some different things going on. And you're going to get more nuance from the other characters. You're going to get
more.
So I think this is one of those plays you're going to want to see two or three
and
times.
I hope that it's one that you want to see several times and then you're still talking about it like weeks from now and singing the songs, right? Because they're so catchy.
So in my poor promo, I said it was a
It was not a poor promo, it was great. I said we were happy to have it.
A three-act play.
Yes.
It is not a three-act play. It's a two-act play.
It is a two-act play.
But in my defense, and you even said this, yes. One that threw me the idea and bailed me out here was the third act is almost the curtain call. Because you'll want to just to be a part of that, I thought, oh,
big deal.
What can a curtain call be?
It's pretty cool.
It is a big deal because, one, these songs, now, I don't know what era, you know, everybody watching.
Right, yeah. Okay?
But I'm kind of a guy of the 80s, mm-hmm, you know, and maybe late 70s, early mm-hmm. 80s. And this is ABBA.
Yes.
And so it's fun music. There's not one
so
song
fun.
There's not one song in the whole musical that's like, yeah, okay.
There isn't.
And matter of fact, our conversation last night was, did we hear that? We were going back through all the songs. And you hear all these songs, you're like, oh, did ABBA do that?
Right, yes.
You know, and you're like, oh, wow.
Oh, they did, yeah.
And so it's pretty cool.
It
and
is
so
very cool.
Everybody identifies with these songs. So talk about what you think, how you think that's going to go over with
Oh, my gosh.
The curtain call is going to be a phenomenal thing, I think.
I don't want to give it away. So I'm not going to say anything else, but, like, stay for the curtain call. You'll love the curtain call. Because it isn't just a curtain call. It's a whole nother, like, show kind of. So stay for the curtain call. Take a nap if you need to, if it's late. But I'm serious. You'll want to stay for all of it because it's all so great. Yes, the music alone in this is just... it's so catchy. You can't help but sing it. The kids constantly are singing it in my classroom. We're like, oh my gosh, Ms. Moore, we couldn't quit this with this one song. Wouldn't get out of my head last night. And I'm like, I love this. This is so fun. And I have to tell you, so it's been a long process, right? I mean, we've been singing and doing this for a long, you know,
long
2.5+ months. And so Saturday I had kind of reached, as a director and anybody doing anything for a long period of time, I'd kind of reached my like, okay, I just need to take an afternoon. Because again, I'm here Saturday, Sunday, after school.
Absolutely.
I'm living it because that's just what you do. And loving it, don't get me wrong. But Saturday I needed a scotch of a breather and I thought I'm going to go home and I'm just going to do something different. I'm not going to sing any songs. I'm not going to listen. I'm just going to not Mamma Mia today for the rest of the afternoon. Because we'd already had practice. And I literally went in the other room. My kids asked if they could turn on the Masked Singer. And I said, sure. So they turned on the new. It was an ode to ABBA.
Oh, my gosh.
And it was all Mamma Mia songs. And I thought, you've got to be kidding me. I literally can't. But again, I was like, okay, I get it. This is my life and I love it, right? Yeah. You know, so it was just funny because Mamma Mia has gone back on tour, it's kind of repopulated, right? So now it's more, whereas it maybe have been forgotten a little bit, it's kind of coming back and having a resurgence, which is cool for us because it makes it relevant right now. So.
I've seen parts of the movie, and I'll be honest with you, I didn't think it translated really good on screen. I didn't really like that so much, but
the
production is so much better.
Agreed.
Just because, I think it's because it's live and in front of you, and the music is very lively.
Yes.
And it just kind of...
You can't help but like.
It's, you know...
you can't.
From the disco era, or whatever you want to call it, I mean, that music was made to make your body move. I mean, literally, physically, that is the design.
Yes.
Of the rhythms and the
even
the sounds.
Slow, like you said, even the slow ones is like you're still like, oh yeah, you know, feeling it. So
and to see, I just want to say this too, that I think the whole crew, what I saw last night, the whole crew, stage, mm-hmm. backstage, actors, staff, everybody, it's a very collegial atmosphere. I mean, it is reminiscent of a play done in the 50s and 60s. My dad used to be on stage with some goofy stuff.
Your
dad did.
Yeah.
So, but it has that same feeling. And I'll just say this: what you talked about your lifestyle on the farm, and we don't do this. We don't get into video games.
Yes, which makes us sound really dull, I guess.
No, but let me just tell you, it's refreshing because those kids down there are not running out of there to get back to their video game or back to what they were doing. That they are there
mm-hmm.
with those people in the moment, in the play. I mean, they are bought in. They are in it, and they're not. You don't have to coax them.
Yeah.
To get back. I went to eat with my son last night. He's like, oh, "We got to get back. Get it back. Get it back." And he never says that.
Yeah.
And he's not concerned about it. So he's excited to be there. I think all the players are excited to be there. All the staff is excited to be there. They all see the work. So it's a very, you can say whatever you want to, but I'm just saying all of that stuff is translated from your approach to that. I think it's very, very good. So anyway, there's just no doubt about it. You got to come see it. Now, we talked about the edgy thing. Yes.
Sure.
But
But what isn't edgy in this world? I mean, we're exactly. there's you know, it's a large world out there. There's lots of things.
In context, there's probably a lot of other things that you could, that could be a lot worse.
Absolutely.
You know? So this is very mild.
Yes.
And the way it's presented is very mild.
Yes, very much so. Yes.
So, I mean, I think anybody, if you have a concern about that, just come watch it.
Yes.
And then find out yourself. Just
sure,
watch
absolutely.
It once. If you don't like it, just watch it once, because I'm telling you.
Or come and then leave if it's you're uncomfortable, but I guarantee you won't, because it's so good.
You won't want to leave. I can tell you that once you get in there. So, what else do you have that you want to? I want to talk about our
stage crew for a little bit, because so early on we don't bring them in so much, you know, because we're still getting the feel for everything, and so they kind of come in late in the game, which is a plus and a minus, because now you have all these people that have now, like you said, built this atmosphere and this bond, and you know, really focused in, and then there's people come in here in their, you know, in their area,
right.
And that's hard. And I watched that happen very first night, and I thought, this is, you know, we can't do this. It can't be us and them.
Right.
And so, but you take a couple nights and one talk with the cast and crew, and everybody's fine. You know what I mean? So I love that they embrace them, and they are awesome, because you have to depend on your crew. If you don't have your lighting and your sound and your people moving all the things off as you come in, and I mean, it won't be the same. And
exactly.
And it's noticeable, or you go, oh, they forgot.
Punch,
so it is so awesome to have. We are blessed to have stage crew, great prop people, great stage people that work, you know, awesome together, and just,
absolutely.
And again, Miss Arnold is kind of heading that up, and just does a phenomenal job. So that's key. Well, all these supporting people are so key.
I thought, I'd been there a little bit, and then I came back last night, and I thought, well, this has the potential of moving pretty slow between transitions, because you've got
a lot going on. Sometimes, yes.
And, man, I've seen plays die on the vine when it's really good.
I know. The momentum is lost.
4 minutes between scene changes, and you're like, everybody's got to get back up to where you were.
Yes.
It's not like that either. I mean, that is what the stage crew has done. I mean,
yes.
I was impressed last night that they were able to, you know, and they're just going to even get better.
Yes.
So, I mean, but it's a fast-paced, it really is it's got to stay moving.
It is. So, and I'm glad you brought that up, because in a lot of plays, it's, you know, lights out, and then you change stuff, and then lights back on.
Right.
And a lot of times with this, it's low lighting, but like we're moving, and there's music still playing to get and go, and it's really fast change.
Right.
And so they've done this. The stage crew is awesome. I love them.
The continuity of that, I think, is translated really well. So you've done a really good job on that part.
Well, good.
I think that the bottom line is, you just going to want to go watch it.
Go watch it. So
I don't think there's just some kids in this production that you aren't going to get to see. It's not like they're going to be here for years and years and years.
Yes.
And so this is a pretty special time for them. And I can guarantee you that every kid that is in this production will remember it for the rest of their lives. It will be a big marker for them, because when you overcome stuff, and when you're influenced by the work ethic and the way that you have approached this, you've done your job as a teacher. I can tell you that. So
thank you.
Teaching degree or no teaching degree, I'm telling you, you're doing a good job
teaching
these guys the craft and teaching them what it takes to work at something and to overcome their inhibitions, you know, to
right,
do it.
Right, sure, because that's huge.
Yeah, absolutely.
We all struggle with that.
And I've just seen people that I thought, I don't think they're going to do very well. Wow.
Good, I love that.
So that's pretty cool. And I'd even say that even for my own kids, that you think, you're not going to get that to happen.
Right.
But you did. And it's pretty cool, because they're bought in, and they like working with you.
I love it. I love all of them. They are so, and here's the thing about this cast, I'm probably going to get emotional because I love them so much, but they're so unique and they're so individual, and they bring that to their roles and everything that they do, and it's just such a beautiful thing
awesome.
To watch.
Yeah, it's awesome. It is very cool.
I'm just proud.
You're gonna need to come a couple of times to get that total encompassing feeling to watch all of it, because there's so much going on. So
for sure.
Emily, thank you so much.
Yay.
Made you cry.
I know, twice. My students are going to laugh, because I tell them they know how emotional I am. And so, sorry, I cried. It happens.
Well, listen, we're not even doing a distance here. Just come watch the production. You're going to be very impressed with it, and you're going to be very impressed with what these kids have the potential of doing and what they've done.
They're awesome.
In this production. And I think it's a huge undertaking for a first year. My gosh.
I'm learning that.
I don't know what you're going to do next year.
Really?
Pretty good start.
Well, thank you.
And even to get, you know, like I said, getting a compliment from Don Amon is no small task.
That is very true.
And he almost gave you one.
He almost did. It was so close. Yeah, I'm glad you said that.
Almost,
I'm glad he said that.
Almost gave you one. We're giving Don a hard time. But anyway, everybody's done a good job, and they're all trying to do better and better and better every night. And
they are.
You got to come watch the first show. The only transition you're going to get is the first show and the last show. So I would book those two for sure.
Yep.
And then catch the other two or three in between.
Yes,
but
yes.
It's all good. So
yep.
Anyway, we want to thank you guys. Thank you, Emily, for being on,
yes,
on the
welcome.
Show.
Yes, you're welcome. Thanks for having me.
I wish I had every guest like you. Animators.
Awesome. I can't. I had a teacher tell me, put your hands on the table and talk. I can't do it. I'm sorry, I can't. And they move.
Well, I'm just saying, it's exciting to have you up here. You haven't been in the studio in a while.
It's been
several years.
Yeah.
We won't mention that many, but anyway, it's been a while.
Thanks.
But thank you for all you're doing. And thank you. And congratulations on what you're doing at the school. I think it's a great decision for them. And I think you're proving that very much. So,
thank you, Jeff. So I appreciate that.
You're doing
a great job. Thank you.
All right. Well, that's it for today. We kind of a little bit longer than we thought, but it's Emily Moore, so of course you were. So anyway, next week Jennifer Hickson, so be here with that, and be sure to send us like us on Facebook, even though Emily is not going to ever do that. But like us on Facebook and send us an email 102studioshow102@gmail.com, and if you want to see somebody on the show, we'll go try to get them if they'll allow us to put them on. So anyway, we'll see you next week right here at 10:30 on the Studio Show. Thanks for watching.
Thank you for watching The Studio Show. People, community, progress.